Yep.
How does it look? I mean, what kind of?
Hi there.
Hi.
I'm here for the 1:30.
Okay.
I guess I got a little while to wait.
Commissioner's office? Hold on just a moment.
Hey, Sunday?
Hey, how are you?
There's a key in this. I have a key to get in the office.
It's all my desk.
On your desk?
You can use mine.
Okay.
Yeah.
How you doing?
I'm doing very well, thank you.
Good. Is it here?
It is here. If you want to just have a seat, they'll call everybody back when they're ready.
All right, fantastic, thank you.
You're welcome.
We're here for that 1:30 jail meeting.
Okay, if you'll just have a seat, they'll call you back when they're ready.
American history, we can visit for 1865.
Look at this.
Shocker.
Should be the outpost.
Hey, Virgil, how you doing?
Hey, baby.
You called me last week.
Dutch hall, nice to see you.
Awesome. I think you picked up on him.
I talked to David.
Later that evening.
When did we talk?
Thursday, right?
Thursday.
This is pretty cool.
I'm coming out tomorrow.
What's this on?
1865.
Oh. The fan. You guys keep that on all the time.
Have you read that book, Killing Lincoln? That O'Reilly wrote?
The fan that putting in the cool.
But you.
No.
The negative pressure medical.
Just ran into Doug.
That young man is kind of a Swiss one. I didn't go up there.
Step one, it's one of those things, I think.
So I do. When you're in the room.
That could be, that would be full-time.
That's pretty cool. Newspapers.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I don't know.
Really?
That is my fortune cookie today. You see it? You're recognized and honored as a community leader. Interesting fortune cookie, isn't it?
How appropriate, yes.
See it.
Yeah, yeah.
What if I was a prison somewhere?
Exactly. But Georgia wasn't.
Really?
Right.
I think the meeting's in there.
Yes, indeed. Just waiting to be called back.
Hi, Scott.
Yeah, she's loaded. Family photos, gravestones, all those kinds of things. She was an East customer. Added to the train.
I know, that's exactly.
Yeah, they, you know, kids, kids into the mayor.
Absolutely.
I There's an organization that holds some showcases and things for town.
Hello.
The number one organization. And most of the major leaguers go to the project. This is sir. Yeah, I was just trying to say, you know, information shared, you get this council there. This is a global year there.
Barcode kids or something. Well, I went back over. Tell the mayor, we're all kind of, they were going to be from immediately 30 and so.
So I think it's a ball.
Yeah, the next morning, Amos has my soccer
system. Yeah. So I think NASA's ball and lacrosse.
Who says no that you're supposed to turn.
Probably somebody that I know where I'm at.
They were going to do that.
That's what I thought.
What is it?
That was
some of the things that
said. What's that called? Fair?
They had some down there.
Y'all come on back.
I had Chinese today. I'm going to go 14. Let me give you some glasses.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Do you got any I can borrow?
Well, they've given you one that's already happened.
Isn't that awesome? Well, that was the day to day people. Look, he was here. You got hired in the bank.
I am.
I'm not supposed to be in the
bank. You got it in there. You got it over there.
It's just one. No. Just that pair.
How are you? Thank you. Good to see you, sir.
I sent that email to Chad.
Good.
He tells me. He must have downed it.
I'll get him a set.
Oh, I gave it to him. I forwarded it now.
Thank you for being here today. This is the SPLOST 7 Jail Courthouse Project Team meeting scheduled for today at 1:30 p.m. We have recognized a quorum, and the first thing is to call the meeting to order. The first item on the agenda is adoption of the agenda. Are there any recommended changes to the agenda?
Move we adopt the agenda as presented.
Second.
Okay. Have a second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Hearing none, that passes unanimously. Next item is the adoption of the minutes. This is for the meeting of July 30, 2012. You have those in front of you, or you have received them previously. Is there a motion to adopt the minutes of the July 30th meeting?
So moved.
Second.
Motion and second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Being done, that passes unanimously. The next item is item four, item for consideration and discussion. Item one is consideration of recommendation from the Architectural Services Selection Committee regarding an architect and engineer for the jail and courthouse project. I believe we have Donna Kukarola here today, and I believe there are also some selection committee members here with us today as well to speak to this and answer any questions you might have. Donna?
Thank you, sir. And that is correct. We have many members of the selection committee with us. I'd like to pass this out. This is basically an overview. Please remember this was a qualification-based solicitation. We had eight firms actually submit proposals to the county. After the technical review, there was a short list of three firms, which we interviewed. After the interviews, just so you have the process a little bit, after the interviews, we then opened the pricing, and we were allowed to negotiate and talk to the firms. The lowest score, of course, means it's the highest ranked. After careful consideration by the committee, the recommendation is to award it to Wakefield Beasley and Associates, as they presented the qualifications that we think will best suit our needs for the county.
Their ranking was almost double. Any rest out?
Right, and lower, yes, the highest rate.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. After the technical ranking, you'll see I have them highlighted. It was Wakefield, then Piper, then KSGW. And then after the interviews, the ranking changed somewhere. It was Wakefield, KSGW, and then Piper. And again, like I said, we did not open pricing until after that fact. And this is their best and final. It is inclusive of all the requirements that we have. We did ask to add a traffic study, and that was done. They did include the off-site utility design. Previously in their proposal, there had been some notations of the vault and scrub. Everything is as should be required to meet our design and engineering services.
So the price of extra $130,000 was enough to sway you from Wakefield?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And the team is here if you have any questions from them as well.
Are any of these three local or part of them local?
I think all of them actually have members that live within Forsyth County, all of the firms.
You mean members, employees of the
employees,
firms?
Yes, sir. Yes.
What do you need us to do?
Well, is there any other discussion, any questions for the selection committee?
I just noticed that KSGW was next after Wakefield. Is that mm-hmm. right? I mean, barely between Piper, O'Brien, and KSGW. They were like 10. KSGW was 10, Piper was 12. Mm-hmm. So, and the difference, they were very close in price. KSGW was like only.
Just around the $25,000.
Mm-hmm.
Does any of them have a firm or an office here local, or just an employer to local?
I don't think there's any offices in the county, but I just want to put a caution on that because that's not one of our requirements, and it is over the threshold of even of our local preference.
I that's what I was going to ask. As long as that takes preference, but you understand that?
Oh, definitely.
We've always are leaning toward trying to keep jobs local whenever we can.
Absolutely. I understand that.
How much work has Wakefield performed in the county?
We have not, actually, we've not done work with either Wakefield. Well, we did the program study with them, I take that back, I'm sorry, but we've not done any other projects besides this one. And we've not done any with KSGW, but we have worked with Piper in the past. And Mr. Merritt just wanted to remind everyone, or bring it to the forefront, that they will have a, they, meaning Wakefield, has agreed to have a local office, I want to call it an office or a space, anyway, space is a better word for it, for, especially the first few months, so that during the conceptual design and whatnot, it's very easy for the commissioners and the judges and the people that need to see it can come in and look at it and see what's going on. So that, that is a consideration as well, and that is included.
Included and at their cost,
yeah.
That's okay. Commissioner asked a question earlier about where do we go from here. It's similar to what we did with the program manager. This board would simply vote on this item, and if you agree to move forward with it, it would then go to the Board of Commissioners at the next meeting?
At tomorrow's,
tomorrow's meeting.
Work session.
Yes. Work session.
That's one more.
Yes.
What, no, was it in the selection committee, was this a unanimous vote for Wakefield?
Yes, it was.
Okay. On that, Mr. Chairman, I'd make a motion that we accept the Wakefield proposal for the architect duties, since it's a unanimous vote by our selection committee, and to make it time sensitive.
Can I say one thing? I've got a proxy here from the mayor.
Yes.
I think it's important that we, I have not opened it, Sam delivered me a few minutes ago.
Well, that's, yeah, right for the vote, at least, because you can read this.
Yeah,
vote.
Yeah.
I don't think you read it out loud, though, for swearing anybody's vote. I think you just.
I'll second the commissioner's motion.
Okay. There's a motion and a second. All those in favor to select Wakefield Beasley and Associates as the for architectural services and engineering design work for the jail and courthouse, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? And the mayor's proxy vote is for Wakefield Beasley and Associates as well. The next item of business is similar to what we did when the selection committee for the program manager was completed, and that is consider dissolution of the Architectural Services Selection Committee. As far as I know, there will be no other use for them at this point. Is there a motion to dissolve that committee?
Thank you. I'll
second.
Yeah.
Okay. There's a motion and a second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed.
Can you kind of tell me this release?
I will tell you, this
we
is a great team.
Reconsideration.
That was is a wonderful team to work with. They were very dedicated and took this as seriously as they needed to, and I appreciate working with all of them.
We want to thank y'all for all the serious work y'all did. Thank y'all for doing that.
They did good work.
Okay, passed. Item three is the project update by the program manager.
Hey, you want the screen?
Please.
I think the screen came down over there.
Yes, it does.
And now I walk on by. Don't do that to me. That's good. That's scary.
That was a good time.
Okay, let's match it.
I'm going to start out with status and talk about a little bit about program confirmation, some project-related issues. Go through approvals this body will need to make in the next 30 months. And then we go to project finance and reports with the agenda.
Did you say 30 months?
30 months. Where we are today is that we have submitted to the county, and it is in review, project management, architectural engineering, and team of risk contracts. So those are in review with the county. Right now, we have completed the preliminary schedule, and it has been approved by this body and the commission. The same thing with the delivery method of CM at risk. But the vote for tomorrow, I would say the architectural selection is 90% complete. There's a procurement out and some for testing and surveying. The surveying prices have been received, so we're close on that one. A cash flow estimate has been completed and submitted, and we're going to talk about that at the end of the presentation. The program confirmation is about 85% complete. We've had two sets of meetings going on simultaneously, one with the judge's staff, and then the other one with the sheriff's staff. And then a preliminary budget is about 65% complete, and there's some components that we need to follow up on and complete. On the jail space summary, what we've identified is about 19,000 square feet of space. Part of that was identified but not accounted for. About 11,000 of this overage is in outdoor space. Some programmers recognize it and put a half cost or a lower cost on it. Some don't recognize it and take care of it in the cost per square foot. What we're doing is accounting for it, mostly in this number. We've also added a magistrate criminal hearing room to the jail. Now what that does, it's about a savings of about $300,000 a year and about $405,000 of extra cost. So the payback of adding that criminal justice hearing room is about 1.3 years. Because it's going to eliminate 95% of the transports that we're going to have to do between the jail and the court. So the magistrate judge was very cooperative and suggesting it's a no-brainer for him to have a hearing room there. So that's what we've had added in that regard. The other thing that I want to talk to the committee about is I'm going to ask today for authorization to relook at the demographics. And more specifically the jail inmate capacity estimates. Reason being, if right now the county is about 2 per 1,000 of incarceration rate, you're about 180,000 people, there's 360 inmates. If you take that incarceration rate and project it to the year 2030, it comes up to be about 740 capacity. So that's almost 20 years out. What we'd like to do is, since what we're seeing all over the country is the inmate population is coming down, so we'd like to take another look before we nail down that capacity and then report back to this committee about what we find.
What was your percentage of population growth per year for your projection?
The study, I think it was a 2008 study or a 2010 study that projected 10 at 183,000. And then 2030 at 370,000. Okay, now I just took this off the web and some of the study that was already previously submitted. But I think the study was done before the downturn, I'm not sure.
That's what I was wondering about, because if you look at what's happening already this year, building permits, I'll take a look.
Well, it's good to know now. Yeah. Before you go and invest all this money in this jail, so that you know where you're going. Overbuilding's a problem, underbuilding's a problem. So trying to nail it right in the middle is what we're after. On the court program, we've got a savings. And the judges and the judges' staff have been very, very cooperative in working with us. And what we've identified is a way of arranging the space that is a lot more efficient than it was previously programmed as. And one of those ideas is to locate all the judges on one floor. Locating all the judges on one floor compared to locating the judges with a particular court set saves a lot of card space, unidentified space that we can find. So we've got a good savings on that that almost offsets the other. So from where we are today, that situation, we're on par with the cost that's already been projected. So we're not over budget, we're not under budget. We've got some ups and downs, but we're right on target. This is a little graph just showing the difference in the old program, the new program, and where we're going, not much difference at all, but it, you know, every dollar counts. We also have a stacking diagram, a preliminary stacking diagram that talks about what goes on each floor. With the judges on the fifth level, you can see that we don't have a building that goes straight up yet, but we've got the functionality described. Essentially, everything that wants to be on the ground level for public access, clerk of court, some things like that, recognize that right now the real estate function is still over on the old court for the clerk of court. And then second level is district attorney, solicitor, things like that. Third and fourth are court levels, and then the fifth is the judge level. This is a very, very secure way of arranging the courts because you're dropping the judges down to the courtroom and then you're bringing the inmates up so they never meet.
You know, how many floors were the preliminary program?
I mean, what?
Floors?
Three
or four?
I don't know. I think there was a statement in the study talking about four floors.
Okay.
But I don't think the site will handle four floors because it's just not big enough.
Okay.
Now, one of the things that happens, though, there's a 20-foot drop between the front, this side of the site and the back side of the site. So introducing some lower space may make part of this first level down here, down on the basement level. Okay. So, and we hadn't got to that level of design. That's why I mentioned that we're about 85% or 65% complete. But there's all kinds of options in this arrangement because of the site will help us. In some cases, it hurts a little bit. And while I've got you, let me talk about one thing. We're still studying the difference between the bridge and the tunnel. With a 20-foot drop, a tunnel saves two elevators. The bridge creates two elevators. Now, of course, the bridge is cheaper than the tunnel. But in some cases, we looked at some design options where we may not even need a bridge or a tunnel. So that's yet to come. So I'll just tantalize you with that little piece of information and then, come forward with some more ideas. Let me summarize a couple of things because there's some real important tasks that need to occur so we don't miss the schedule. One is we have maybe a change in the sheriff, or probably a change in the sheriff. And we need to get to the sheriff candidates and brief them so whoever wins the election, when we start day one, we're not going backwards, we're going forwards. So we need to do that as quickly as we can. I've already talked about checking the demographics from the jail inmate population projections. Talked about the putting the magistrate court or the criminal part of the magistrate court over at the jail building, which saves a bunch of money. And the fact that the impact, because most of the space that we're talking about within that 19,000 square feet is outdoor space, really is not having an impact on the jail. On the court side, program building is smaller. Courthouse may be five stories, okay? The bridge versus the tunnel versus neither, and no action necessary right now, but just so you're aware of where we're going. One thing that we've come up with in talking with everybody, all the different departments, all the different judges, we know we need to close that street. All right, and let me tell you why. No matter what happens, there's always going to be traffic back and forth between the existing court and the new court. It's always going to be there. The street's going to do nothing but get busier. It's always going to be a safety issue. And so to solve it now would be important to the planning of the jail. In working with DOT in the past, I know that they are particularly sensitive to the safety issue, especially in a downtown square, because they've had to deal with it so many times. So what I'm asking for today with y'all's permission is to initiate some of those discussions to see if we can close it. Because knowing today that we can, whether we can close it or not, kind of at the top level with the county government and state government, is important to the schedule as well. Some of the kind of central planning issues for the overall project is, and I've talked to everyone about this, is putting a central energy plant and a central maintenance function. So the maintenance function is shared between sheriff and judges and that whole complex. It's a much more efficient way of doing things because you're sharing staff. Each one of the buildings don't have enough building area. They pull five full trays. If you combine them, they do. We need the estimate for the finance cost quickly so we can nail down this budget. We also need the estimate for the permitting and tap fees. I'd like your permission to work with the city and sit down with the city and come up with that number to the best of our ability. And then Donna's already talked about it, but if we could get a central place, it needs to be downtown, because what we're after with the war room or the place where everybody comes see the design is so it's easy for you guys to come see this design and sit down over the drawings. What we don't want is sucking a lot of your time away from what you're doing. We know you got full-time jobs. So if there is a space, 400 square feet, that we could have for 4 months, that would be a big plus to the project. Now the other thing I've done is in your package is come up with a list of things that this committee is going to see throughout the whole project. Now there may be other items, but as a minimum you're going to see these things. There are those things, those approvals and recommendations go over to the county, in most cases go over to the county and commission, county commission for approval. But when we're talking about studies like this authorization to do a demographic study, I come back and report to this team first, and then if there's any change, it's ready to go to commission. I think this captures the intent of this committee, but you're going to have to tell me if I'm right. And I don't expect an answer to go through this whole list right now in the next 2 minutes, but if you get a chance to get back to me about that, I'd appreciate it. Now we're at the cash flow part. This is the recent estimate of cash flow for the project, and it goes from obviously nothing to some plus $8 million months when we're in the middle of construction. And one of the things that has to be recognized about this project is that we're really building three buildings at the same time, and we're renovating two after that. So it's a pretty complex project from the standpoint of all the activities going to be occurring in a very small space. Getting the finance charges identified now is going to allow us to nail down this budget. And do remember this, the more the finance charge is, the more pressure it puts on the building size.
Based on your cash flow, and you may have a further page here, if so, I'll hold up. No, you don't. Do you have any kind of an idea of what we're looking at for loans?
That's where the finance director and I have spoken. He had a good number to begin with, but now his number is not so good.
Oh. Should I have a talk with him?
I think he's going to present now. If it's Mr. Chairman, isn't that on your agenda?
It is. It's part of it, yes. Do you want to go over, before we move on to that, and I know these are kind of blended, do you want to go over any action items? You just went over a lot of information. Do you need direction from this committee? It sounded like you did on some of these matters. Joe?
Yes, sir. I need, on the jail, I need permission to go back and look at the inmate projections. And what we'll do is, my planning department has already agreed to do that. I know it wasn't part of our scope, but we're just going to put a couple of people on it and just find out. So we're not even asking for anything about it.
With your permission, I do believe that hopefully one of the new sheriffs won't be locking everybody up on the small misdemeanor charges, like a lot of jurisdictions are doing proxy charges and such like that. So with that, maybe you'll look at those numbers as well in reality. A little lower starting point.
I agree. And looking at the county at this stage, I think there's an opportunity to help the county out with those numbers. It would be a better number.
You need this for a budget?
I don't know that we need. Does this committee feel like we need it in the form of a motion or no. Without exception?
Just without exception, I think.
Okay.
And then the other thing I need is to meet with the city. So if the same would apply, just go meet with the city, determine, get the tap fees and the permit fees and all those other things.
And at the same time, would you be talking to them about the closure, street closure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And Joe, do you mind if start with the committee to also begin dialogue with them with respect to permitting, building height, stories, that type of discussion as well?
Include DOT in there as well.
And any direction from the county on how to approach DOT at the top levels would be helpful too.
We can help with that.
Okay.
Okay, those without exception. The other that I have noted is the central work area you discussed earlier.
Yes, sir.
300 to 400 feet.
Now that's feet. Already in the
central. Yeah.
Okay.
I'd like to explore that a little with staff. We have been looking at office space for other departments. It's been limited, especially the space that's close to downtown. I would just like an opportunity, if it's all right with the committee, to explore that with Dave Thornton and see if we can't come up with some office space for that work area.
Miguel, would the city have any space? Should we talk to them as well?
We can, absolutely we can. This is a joint project, jointly funded for SPLOST 7. And think that it makes sense to have that discussion with the city and see if they have some space that's available to us. Be glad to do that.
Not trying to be picky. All I'm trying to do is get so close to downtown that everybody, you know, really has some good access.
Yes. Okay.
Now we're at the cash flow.
Okay, cash flow.
Ready?
Yes.
Okay. With a few pieces of information that have changed now, I've updated the cash flow model. And this is, I like changes first and where I think we're at. First of all, using the new construction schedule compared to the purely preliminary construction schedule we had. And it really is a little quicker, accelerates a little bit by a few months what compared to the preliminary schedule we were working on, so we need more funding sooner. That and the other change that dropped in was the timing right now looks like we would need money, have some cash available beyond what the general fund's been helping with right now. Our financing should close probably about January, and if we start with January, then we'll have borrowed a sufficient amount, we'll have good enough cash flow through the term of the project. Putting those changes in, what the model showed me to hit the low spot and have enough cash through the entire project is, instead of before it looked like it might have been $40 million, right now for the courthouse and jail looks like we would need to borrow about $50 million.
That being so, I looked at then the two paths we've been considering, bank financing, bank loans, if you will, or notes or bonds. And the committee recall, last time I reported on this, it was sort of right in the middle at a $40 million amount, repaying as quick as possible. And the principles there, I think, brought out was larger dollar amounts, longer term, tend to lean toward bonds. Shorter and smaller tends to lean toward bank financing. As I drop these new numbers in here, I'm starting to see some separation that's going to really point more toward, as far as the dollars are concerned, toward bonding. Using same schedule for payoffs, so the same term.
What term are you using for payoff?
I went to the longer term, and I'll explain why in a minute. So it would be, and the referendum limited how much could be paid back each year. So going back to paying back $15.5 million in 2019, $15.5 million in 2018, $15 million in 2017, and then remaining $4 million in 2016. So that's the longer payout term. I'll mention now why, because the other consideration in addition to $50 million was what about funding for other projects? And I looked at that, basically, and again, what's taking the hit here in the interest and borrowing costs is the courthouse and jail. If we added $10 million more to the borrowing, that could add as much as another $500,000 in interest and financing costs. So what the better way probably to work that is to push out the financing a little bit longer. That means dollars would come available for other projects beginning around 2015, beginning 2015. So that's the other way to do it, is you push back the payback as opposed to borrowing more. And at least this model right now is pushing out the payback. And we'll run it every advantageous way we can. That being said, and I used, even for this comparison, so it's going to be a little bit wider, I used the shorter term bank rates, which right now would run a little bit more than 2%, maybe about 2.1%, depending on how you negotiate with the banks. They can do fixed rates. It would be a little bit higher than that, but I didn't have a quote and factor that in. Borrowing the notes only as you need them, so you don't have to get all the money up front. I came up with total cost on the bank route of about $5.25 million. A little over $5,273,000 here. With the bonds having to borrow it all up front, but a much lower rate, and the bonds at so low rates now compared to variable, even if you were to fix this, the average weighted rate would be about 1.5%. Adding higher bond costs than bank loans came out to just over $4.9 million. So I'm getting actually a bit more than that, probably $4,950, let's say. So I'm getting separation of about $300,000 difference in the two options. And that's using more, that's assuming short-term rates would stay low, the LIBOR rates would stay low, these are based on. So that spread could easily get larger. I use the most advantageous, not exactly like the bank loans. In other words, if you want the fixed bank loan or variable rates start to go up somewhere in the next 6 to 7 years, that $300,000 could easily be a few hundred thousand dollars more. So it's starting to point toward bonding, unless we borrow a lesser amount, or as I try to run some models for the shorter term, but then we won't have dollars for other projects until 2016, 2017. So those are the kinds of
Have you actually sat down with our main bank we use right now, the United Community Bank, and had a discussion with them about what it will cost us?
Right, and actually his was, without giving a quote from him, it was his interest rate quotes I used as a model for these costs. So.
But that was what, some time ago, wasn't
it? I called him actually this morning again to see if he had any changes, and he said pretty much it's still a good term sheet. And he said when it came down to it, if we chose bank financing, we could negotiate some. But I'm not seeing much of a difference in what banks are just able to do, just as being a bank, what their costs are and so on. There's enough separation between these two now. Because the dollar amount and going longer term. If we borrowed less or if we brought it back in shorter term, it would tend to narrow that gap again. Pretty much basic borrowing principles when you look at what type of funding to do. Basically, because the fixed cost of bonds gets spread out over a larger amount or longer term, becomes more advantageous.
Is there any arbitrage in that at all?
I had not calculated that in, because you would earn some on the bonds because you borrowed all up front, and that would make more advantageous for the bonds as well. So, as far as the total dollar cost, right, we'll have to be moderated a little bit by that. So I'm looking at if we went with bonds, up to, could be less than right now, depending on the market. And if we would go to market in January, so we'll see if the interest rates are down, up to $5 million, could be less.
What do we get if we bond that and stick CDs or whatever? You get a half, you get three quarters?
Oh, we invest them. Well, our earnings rate is so low right now.
You get a half?
Unless we were to ladder some CDs, which we can do through certain programs called CDARS. you can, if you're really aggressive around the country, we could get maybe closer to a third of a percent than a quarter or two tenths of a percent, 20 basis points. So we'd earn some, and then it would depend on how fast we drew down the money, but we would save some.
Well, the rules, if I remember correctly, are you got to spend it all in 2 years?
Okay. 2 years. There is some of the qualifications that, depending on the commitments, but the rates are so low on the earning side that the danger of violating arbitrage rules for bonds, as far as IRS is concerned, is really minimal.
Can you give me the payback schedule again, please?
That particular schedule I use for this comparison, and this lines up with the referendum.
That's what I said.
Yeah. The longest bonds for 2019, and I rounded them a little bit off, $15,500,000. Same $15,500,000 for 2018. $15 million 2017, and then to make it a total of $50 million, $4 million in 2016. Now obviously we could front load some of that and save some interest, but then there would not be funding available for the project. So trying to balance those two things here without adding more borrowing to the $50
million. Payback 2019.
And the payback in 2019.
Is that what you said, this one is paid? Yeah.
That's the longest ones. And I literally went through and calculated out the interest cost, both the bank loan and the bonds, both ways. But not a surprise here, with the $50 million amount, with your long bonds going out for the 6.5 years. Again, those rates, that's a 1.81%. If you were to get the bank to fix something for 6 years, it would be quite a bit higher.
We don't want to have to do this and not have to come in mm-hmm. and get stuck with school board or some of their projects. And they've got these bonds, they've got them now, and that SPLOST has already passed, and they don't have the funds available now.
We got to pay this back out in the SPLOST.
That's what I'm getting at. That's why
their bonds were 20 years old. They based their bonds.
Right. I'm still afraid of going long term.
I base these rates on the refunding we just did earlier in the year, the tax exempt rates for short bonds, the same time period. So those rates are going to be pretty close depending on how the market moves.
But I mean, this is basically a 7 year bond.
You know. The long bonds, right.
Yeah, so that's a short for a bond.
Yeah, that's true.
That's very short term.
Yes, but it still takes right down to the last wire of what our SPLOST does also.
Timing-wise, again, to close in January, if we go the bond route, we probably need to be before the Board of Commissioners in October, say next month, to make a decision as to what underwriters to use, and to give the underwriters to go ahead and start working on it. That would give them 45 to 60 days to have everything in place in December, so you're ready to go to market first thing in January or end of December.
Are we going to ask the banks or the underwriters to make a complete proposal on this, or are we just going to look for the
In my view, that since we had four complete proposals to choose an underwriter this last time, I mean, those are still there standing. I think the board has seen enough information from each of those four to decide whether they want to use the same one again or use one of the others this time to rotate it around. I don't personally feel we need to go back out for whole proposals again. I think we got a good look at what all four of the firms can do for us. So basically I would submit the same four names and say choose from these four again, board commissioners, who you want to use. So that's pretty much the update, I think, where we're at.
And Joe, are you okay with that timetable? I know we've got some expenses we're incurring now. Dave, how are we taking take care of the expenses we incur.
The general fund has basically fronted the ones when we bought the property.
Right.
And as we start getting some small bills in, if Joe wants to get paid, I guess, get some of these bills in. The time schedule, what we were looking at having to cover in January was the first bills being the hundreds of thousands, up to $500,000, maybe $440,000. Smaller amounts in these intervening couple of months. So
just out of the general fund, we're going to handle it?
The general fund's been fronting to this point. So when, as soon as the bonds or the bank financing would be issued, we would, one of the first things we'd do is pay back the first couple $1 million to the general fund.
As far as coming up with enough information in October for you to buy the bonds or go bank finance, whichever mm-hmm. one you decide to go, we're good. We can do that.
Okay. Yeah.
The only thing with moving the schedule around and making it longer is that we got escalation that may come into play then too, especially after this hurricane that just occurred. So, I mean, I can look at it if you want me to, but I don't think you're gonna save anybody that way by pushing the schedule out.
Thank
pushing the schedule out to, for the bonds to pay them off longer, or pushing the construction?
Project, the project.
Project.
Yeah. I don't think you're going to save any money that way just because of escalation may be more than the interest.
Well, I don't know when we might meet again. Is this committee ready to present Dave's findings to the Board of Commissioners for recommendation from them or action from them?
Well, I know there was a real hard push to use banks, but I'd like to at least have a bank proposal in there. Or maybe the bank we use now is in a proposal just to make sure.
I could certainly go back and ask him right now to update his proposal.
Yeah, update proposal.
Using $50 million in this payback schedule.
Yeah, just use him. Just use our regular bank, the bank we already using. Mm-hmm. And make a proposal.
Well, it was one bank that had submitted a term sheet already, so I just asked him to update that.
Okay.
So would that be without exception, or does this committee want to make a recommendation to the Board of Commissioners? If we do, then we would need to have Dave provide those numbers and meet again and before we took this to the Board of Commissioners.
If the bank was able to do a little bit better, did you get any kind of an idea what a little bit better was? Just like a point, like a tenth or?
I don't know. The impression I got is that you get some movement, maybe 5 to 10 basis points, but there's a limit of what banks can do. It's not the same as bonds.
So you'll still be 200 or so apart.
Yeah, and that's short term. I mean, I can get a quote on a fixed rate, so I'm comparing like to like, and then do that and see how big the spread is there.
I don't think you want to do that. That'll make
it be more.
Yeah, the bank's not going to look as promising.
And they offered either. That's,
yeah.
I just like to get a full rate proposal from the bank, just compare it. But I know some people are pushing.
Sure. And you'll have to run some numbers to show us what bond
money
produced for us as well.
And then bring that back to this committee first before making a recommendation to the Board of Commissioners?
I think we have one more meeting, you judge.
Well, yeah, but I've indicated I've abstained from any funding discussion.
That's right.
I'm on a bank board, yes, so I don't want to get into that. Y'all decide that. But.
Oh, we have time. I mean, do you want to call me in before the end of September?
Yeah, I don't mind going, but if reality is we bond $50 million, stick a lot of it in the bank and take it out of our own accounts as we need them, if that's going to produce another $200,000 for us over the time frame, and we're already 200 apart, I don't know that we're going to get where you're trying to be to begin with.
Let's
try to be realistic.
Yeah, it doesn't hurt to have one. We've got time to have another meeting, don't we, Dave?
Yeah.
Okay. I also don't want to miss our bonding opportunities, because right now they're really good. They're like never seen before, and if you wait an extra 30 days, you can lose that too.
We're not going to do it in January,
though. Right. Although,
well, you begin the process.
Begin the process in October.
Right. You want to choose someone in October. And that's something that I've been thinking about too, is how much could the market move if we bond even a little bit earlier, and it would worth additional cost, but rates are so low.
There's crazy. There's low as I've ever been.
I agree with Dave. Since we just had that last recent bond, we've got four people that we can jump on to.
Yeah, they're all ready to go right with it.
You know, so it's not like waiting for a proposal from somebody.
I'm not worried about them, worried about what the market does.
Well, we can still decide by October.
I'm fine. Wait September.
Dave, you think you get numbers from bank
with probably this week. I'll just go ahead and call them again and just talk to them today.
Well, sounds like we won't. The decision we're making today is to have Dave contact the bank, get a proposal from them, and then schedule another meeting and discuss the financing at that next meeting.
And I'll be running harder numbers. I can write up.
Yeah, we can. Yeah, that'll be easy to do.
Mm-hmm.
We can get that.
October's fourth. Like fourth of October is our first board.
The first meeting is on the 4th of October.
I'll have the budget information ready to present to you by the week of the 24th.
Mm-hmm. Update that as well. Sorry, that'd be good.
And I'll plug worst case for that.
would be, that would work then. If you have your budget information ready, Dave has an opportunity to contact the banks, get a proposal from them. Week of the 24th or prior to that, I know you'll talk to them before that, and the first meeting is the 4th. We can bring it to the, we'll have our meeting sometime before that, and then take the recommendation to the board, at the same time discuss if, in fact, they go in the direction of hiring someone to go out for the bonds. We can make that decision at that meeting as well.
We've just done a bond issue, again, the groundwork had already been done, it's in place as far as the rating agency is concerned. If the board chooses someone on the 4th, and you know, they get us in position to go to market in November, again, we can hold and wait till December, January, or go in November if we think the rates are advantageous. So,
would it be appropriate to have the bank or the bonding companies here on next meeting or that day to present?
Dave, do you think it would be advantageous to have a bank or bonding company here at our next meeting for any reason?
I guess, answering quite, I mean, in the meantime, I can have the underwriters. I can have the underwriters, actually, and I did ask one our last underwriters to run us these numbers. That didn't give them enough time yet. They can show us a debt service schedule based on these numbers, but the underwriters could.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, both they and the bank could be there to answer questions. I'm not sure it's, you know, whatever the board wants. I'm not sure how much you're changing.
I know, but I guess you'll change who's interested, see if the four companies are interested. See who's here. Would you mind asking?
Oh, I can ask them. Okay. No problem.
You would want them here that day to answer any questions?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Or for this. The board meeting?
Yeah. Not this meeting. You're talking about this?
Yes, this meeting.
Oh,
not the commissioner's meeting.
Okay. I'll ask them.
Joe, do you have anything else?
No, sir.
Dave, anything else? Anything else needs to come before the board? Okay. Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Motion second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Adjourn. Thank you. Yeah, signatures.
Thank y'all. Yes. You know, I just got dissolved. I even felt it. I felt a little thing. Feel good. Feel a little different. I feel a little better.
I usually don't get the
All right, sign it.
You want to bring that to him so you can get that signed for us?
No, he should have that.
He ain't so proud.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
See you later.
Come here.
Here.
How are you doing?
Here you go. Dave,
you
know
what? See you
sooner or later.
Hey, you want to handle that for us?
Yeah. This meeting is adjourned. I've got another meeting. Two folks.
Oh, my goodness.
Is that for me?
That
was, I already
four.
Did.
Oh, you did?
I signed.
I guess I need more. You wish I had your phone.
Still haven't found
it? Mr. Yeah,
you
that thing.
Okay. Do I need to call you?
Mr.
No,
Mudd?
Yeah.
Do I need to turn on one? He used his own.
make sure that off.